Okay, today I'm going to do question 7 and question 9 from 5.5. Okay, and question 9. Okay, question 7, I've set up the whole thing for you already. So basically, you just have to calculate, right, for each of the amounts that she has, or he has, yeah, she has, okay, we have to calculate how much of the account she has in Singapore dollars. So I'll say that Euro 1720 equals to 17 SGD. 1720 times 1.94. So in this case, she will have 3336.80. Okay, that is for the euro. Let's calculate for the Aussie dollars. Okay, in this case, we have to divide because the SGD is the 1. So I'll take 2516. Okay, SGD 2516 divided by 0.85, and I'll get SGD 2960. And finally, for the Hong Kong dollars, I will take 9824 HKD. 9824 equals to 9 SGD. 9824 multiplied by 0.21. I'll get SGD 2063.04. So the total is just the sum of these three, and I just write plus 2960 plus 2063.04. In total, she has an account is 8359.84. That is question 7. Quite simply done. Just be very clear when you have to multiply and when you have to divide. Don't copy blindly. Think about it. Okay, question 9. Question 9. Okay, the foreign exchange webpage of a bank shows the following. Alright, when the bank... Okay, explain what the above rate says about exchange rate between the Singapore dollar and the Japanese yen. Okay, basically when the bank sells Japanese yen to a customer, so it means you bring money, you bring Singapore dollar to the bank, okay, and the bank, right, will give you 100 yen for 1.3672. So what they are doing here is this. So when the bank sells yen, the money, okay, not me, okay, the rate is 100 yen equals to 1.3672. When the bank buys yen, the rate is for 100 yen. Okay, so that means they will, when they buy yen, means they take in 100 yen, they'll give you 1.3442. Okay, so that's what it means by the foreign web page. Then now, okay, they ask you, if you exchange $1,000 for Japanese yen and back from yen to Singapore dollars, would you get back $1,000? Okay, assuming there's no handling charge. Okay, let's just do it. Okay, let's say there's this guy crazy enough to do this. So first and foremost, okay, first, right, you will, okay, so first the bank sells yen to you. So first you exchange Singapore $1,000 for Japanese yen. Okay, you will get the amount you receive. It's equals to 1,000, okay, 100 yen, so you get $1,000 times 100 over 1.3672. So the amount you receive is 73142.19 yen. Okay, So basically 100 units, right? Okay. Then now, what you get here is this. Now you can exchange it back, right, into Singapore dollars. So you exchange this same amount of yen for Singapore dollars. What happens is this, the amount received is equals to Singapore dollars seven 3142.19 times 13442 over 100, and eventually you will get back 983.18. Okay, so basically, right, due to the differences, in exchange rates, you can't get back the $1,000. We cannot get Singapore $1,000 back. Okay, it's not only, then you say, oh, the bank cheat money. It's only the bank. Okay, it's same for all. Okay, for the what I call money exchanges as well. Okay, when you go and change money, alright, no matter what, you cannot get back the same amount of money. Alright, and that concludes the examples for exercise 5.5.